Hi Glammies, and welcome back to my channel. So this is going to be a drugstore haul, the first one of 2016. January, February, like there's tons of really great products that have come out and I just wanted to like try them all and show you guys what I picked up and what I'll be trying for some tutorials coming up. So let's go ahead and just jump right into it. I just put everything in my Sephora bag and look at that. Like there's so much stuff that like it literally fell and everything's like not where it's supposed to be now. So I'm just gonna grab things and just talk about it as we go. Look at my bag of goodies. I don't have a shopping problem at all. Like Target had buy three John Frieda products or buy three organics products and they would give you a $5 gift card. So I was like, I literally like live at Target. So that's a pretty good deal to get 10 bucks, you know, that can come back another visit and spend it. So anyway, I got the John Frieda Frizz Ease Flexible Hairspray, and I heard it's really good for extensions, because even though I have like a lot of my hair out here too, which is frizzy, the extension hair that I have is really close to my own texture, so I feel like anything with helping with frizz and kind of to maintain the bounciness and minus the frizz, that would work really good. So I got that one. I also picked up the Organics Extra Strength Hydrate and Repair Argan Oil of Morocco Conditioner. It's a mouthful. But this is like extra strength. So when it said extra strength right there, I figure that it would be really good like to really help repair your hair and keep moisture, because like that's the main thing. My hair is just super, super dry. So I wanted to keep it nice and healthy even though I'm using a protective style. I still want to take care of my hair as well. So I'm just going to put the stuff right here. The next thing is from Organics. This is the Renewing Argan Oil of Morocco, and it's another mousse, but I thought it was really cool. Actually, I just love the packaging, to be honest. Like, that ombre kind of gold teal effect is really, really pretty, so I was like, ooh, let's try this because it looks pretty. Not even looking to see if it's going to work or not. It's nice packaging. This is still from Target. This is the Sonia Kushak. This is the brush cleaner, but it's like, it says brush and sponge cleanser, so... The other one I used to use from her was just brush cleaner, so I was curious to see how good this would be from my beauty blender, if it would really like work really good in getting like the oil and dirt out of the beauty blender and like restoring the color. So I thought for $8 I would try this and see how it works out. The next thing I also got from Target was the Garnier Skin Active Micellular Cleansing Water, and this is like new. Like there's so many cleansing waters out, but I've kind of hopped on the bandwagon with that because I absolutely love removing my makeup. Like I have a lot of different makeup removers. Thumbs up this video if you want a skincare video, because with me, like if you guys know, I was working with Chanel, and so I got a lot of skincare products that I start using and a lot of different techniques that I've been using and different products to make my skin look bright and just look even toned, and it's gotten a lot better. So if you guys want a skincare video, thumbs up this video and I will do it the next one that I film. But yeah, so this is this one. I haven't heard good or bad things about it, so I'm just gonna use it and see. But this is for all skin types, even sensitive skin. So I was like, well, I can use it on my eyes, so why not just try it? So the facial spray with aloe, herbs, and rose water. And I have found this was really, really good. I kind of use it in store on my makeup, and it was like really, really calming to the skin. So I heard that was really cool. And I think this was like $7 at Ulta. And I think was it buy one, get one half off? No, this was not. And I couldn't use my coupon on either. It was something else that was half off. But anyway, it was like $7 for the small one. So I thought after using it in the store, my skin felt really, really good. So I was like, let me go ahead and get it. So I tried that out. I am like obsessed with drugstore lashes. And if you guys are like me and you love lashes, and like I'm always wanting to go to, what is it called? The Lash Place, Lash something. Oh man, why can I not think of it? I'll insert it somewhere here. But anyway, they're the more popular ones all the gurus use. And even though I love ordering, you can't buy it anywhere. So I have to like order it, wait for it to come on, you know, in the mail. And it's just like, oh, whatever, I want my lashes now. So I wanted to pick up some new lashes that just came out this year and see if how I like these. And I absolutely love them. These are the Bring the Salon Home Kiss. And these are the Natural Flourish Blooming Lashes. And they're so pretty. The one I got was peony, and that's actually what I'm wearing right now. I bought like four of these because these are my favorite. And it's really cool because it has that multi-angle technology. So when you look to the side, you have like wispies kind of like wisping out, and this makes them look like natural. Like, I don't know if you can see the the model, but they look like natural lashes coming out of your eyeball. So I was like, yeah. And I also got Tulip, which is another nice one. And these are a little bit more thicker than the Peony. But they're just so, so pretty. I have a lot of things that my friends are like, you have to try this stuff. And so this is like one of the recommendations from one of my friends. And these are the Bring the Salon Home. This is another Kiss product. Kiss is like moving on up there. Like they have some amazing things out this year. So this is the Kiss Gel Fantasy Ready to Wear Gel Nails. And I have just been on a gel nail or like a press-on nail kind of kick. And these are absolutely gorgeous. I'm actually wearing one of them now. This is the pink one. But anyway, I don't use like the press-on that's in here. It also comes with glue. And the glue, like, they stay on forever. Like, for a long, long, long time. So this particular one, I don't know what name this is. It just says KG902. It's like a really pretty oval. And then they have like it's the almond kind of ones. And then it has like the almond just straight like glitter. So, so, so pretty. Bestie from Illinois was like, you have to go to CVS Pharmacy like right away. And I'm like, what is going on? So she's like, they came out with the NYX lingerie liquid lipsticks. And she was telling me how amazing they are. So I picked up, I believe like 6 or 7 of them. So these are all the ones, and they were buy one, get one half off as well. And you can buy them on the NYX website, but I really wanted to buy, like, get the one and get the half off, like, the deal. So I picked up Beauty Mark, which is a really, really pretty, like, I don't know, like a cafe mocha kind of color. And I'm going to do swatches in an end of, video on these, because they seem like they're really, really nice. I haven't even opened them up yet. This one is Honeymoon. I got, what is this, Lace Detail, Teddy, and then Ruffle Trim. So yeah, they all seem like a pretty nudie brown taupey color that's in, like everyone is making a color like that for the lips. And they're just really, really pretty. So when she told me, like, and my bestie has been into makeup forever and a day, so when she told me, like, to go get them, I was like, okay, I have to go and pick these up. And then while I was there, they were putting some new things out for spring from e.l.f. So I picked up these little, let's see, they are called Unique Cream to Powder Blush. So I picked up Rose Royalty, which is a pretty corally pink. And then I picked up Peach Perfection, which, you know, you guys know I love an awesome peach cheek. There's nothing like it. And they're like $4. And that's a lot of product. That was like, let me just open it up and show you guys. That was like, that's a lot of product for like $4. Come on. Okay, here it is. Okay, so this is how it looks. Isn't that pretty? And I mean, that's a lot of product. That reminds me of the MAC, what is it called? Casual Colors, I think. And it has that, because I believe you can probably use this like on your cheeks, of course, and you probably could use it on the lips as well. So I'll go ahead and just swatch it right there so you can see it. It's not powdery. And that's one thing I liked about this, was it being a cream, that it won't be powdery on darker skin because it's like a cream base. So that one's Peach Perfection. So, so, so pretty. So I'll do a video for these two. I just wanted you guys to see how cute the packaging was. And like, e.l.f. is like doing their thing. And like for $4, I don't know if it was $3 or $4. I think it was $4. But the only place that I saw these at, and I've been to like Walgreens and Target and Walmart, the only place that had it was CVS. So if you guys are interested, go to CVS Pharmacy and pick some up. So like the hype of 2015, 2016 is the Nivea Men Sensitive Post Shave Balm. And Nikki Tutorials has discovered this, and every YouTuber, every person that's into makeup has been using it, except for me. So I had just got this like a week ago, and I did open it. It comes in like a cute little box. And I opened it up and I used it for the first time a couple days ago. I love it. Like the fact that it gets tacky on the skin, and then it's almost like a rubbery consistency. So when you put your foundation on, it just holds on to it. Like cement. Like it's crazy how well this stuff works. It does have a little bit of a smell to it, but it's not that bad. Like, once I put it on the skin, I don't really smell it anymore after a couple of minutes. But, I mean, for, I believe this came from Walgreens. You can get it cheaper at Walmart. I think I paid $6.75 for this, and people were saying that it's like $3 at Walmart. So, I would definitely check out Walmart before you check out Walgreens. But anyway, it is awesome. It works so good. And it's like in this really nice glass bottle. Like, I mean, if this had like Benefit's name on it or NARS, like you'd be paying quadruple the price of this, you know, because it works really well and it's a nice packaging. So for it to be a men's shaving balm and for women to be able to use it is amazing. I'm actually going to get another one for my husband because he has super sensitive skin. So when he's like shaving, he gets like little irritations. And so he had used a little bit of this and he liked it. So I'm going to buy his own because I was like, this is mine. Like, this is mine. Like, don't touch it. I'll get your own. This is in the Grand Glamour style. And they just look a lot like my, why can't I think of the lash place that I go? House of Lashes, that's what it is. House of Lashes, that's the awesome one that I always order from. And yeah, it reminded me of the, what are they called? The Pixie ones? Yeah, the Pixie ones that are really, really pretty and full and super, super glamorous. So these are $6 each, so not a bad deal at all. I also picked up from e.l.f., and this was from Target, the Contouring Kabuki Brush, which is new. And when I saw this, I was like, ooh, this looks pretty. Like, I could have fun with this thing. So let me just show you how it looks. And it looks like it would be, oh yeah, you can definitely contour. Oh yeah. Oh, that's nice. This kind of reminds me of the NARS Ika brush or whatever. That's nice for the amount of money. I think this was $4. Or was it $6? I think it was between $4 and $6. All right. So I also picked up, keeping on with e.l.f., I picked up some other brushes. And these are just my regular ones that I kind of like to keep in rotation. This is the powder brush. And then this is the angled blush brush. And this works really good for contouring as well. And they're like $3. This is the L'Oreal True Match Lumi Cushion Buildable Luminous Foundation. And my color is W8, and this is amazing. Like, I had been like dying to try this, and I did. I actually used this on my anniversary weekend, so I have to like show you guys pictures or whatever, but I did use it. It comes with this cute little puff right here, and I actually like to use it with the puff. I used it with this one and then in the beauty blender, and I feel like you get more coverage with the little puff that it comes with. But it looks like this, and then you kind of pop it like that, and the product's in there like a little sponge, if you could see that. So you kind of put it in there and then do your thing. So the color that I got was, like I said, W8, and it's called Cream Cafe. And it's just a really, really nice. I would say if you have a lot of skin issues, especially texture, I don't know if you would like this because it doesn't give you a super full coverage look. It gives you a luminous look. So if your skin is already in pretty good shape, you really like this. If you are having some kind of skin issues with acne or, like I said, textural issues, if you use this, it'd be really good if you use it with like a concealer underneath it and then set it with a foundation powder on top of it just to add more coverage. But I mean, I love it just for a nice natural look where it looks like you're not wearing makeup but your skin just looks even. This is amazing. So I'm actually gonna get another one because I really, really like that, and I feel like it's gonna like sell out once everyone's already on the bandwagon. But that color is like perfect for me. So okay, so I also picked up, this is boring, I picked up the Kiss Maximum Speed Nail Glue because, like I said, I'm into like doing my own nails and going back to like fifth grade when I had the press-on nails, Lee press-on nails. So I picked up another powder brush because I love that. Oh, these are so cool. So I went to Walgreens and I was like, this looks new. And so I picked up, sorry, all the rattling. Okay, so I picked up these new Wet n Wild brushes. So I don't know if you guys have seen these before or not, but they look so cool. I love the packaging. I love the fact that they're white and they have the pink ombre bristles, which is really, really cool. So I picked up the flat top brush, the blush brush, the powder brush, and the contour brush. These are the only ones that were left. Like, literally, it was like these four left, and that was it. Like, they got wiped out, and I had talked to the manager, and he said he just put them out a couple hours ago. So I'm sure there's different other brushes too. They're probably a foundation, and I think they had some eye brushes as well, but these are the only ones I can get my hands on. But I was like, these look so cool. So let me just take one out so you guys can see because I haven't taken it out to see how the bristles are. Because if it's anything like Elf, I know I'm gonna love it. So they're not as firm as Elf. I don't know if I can get a nice contour with this. It is a little flimsy. I'm gonna be honest, like it's a little flimsy, but it's cute. And it does have a little indentation right here for your finger, which is kind of cute. That's a nice little, but yeah, I don't know. We'll see. You know what this might be good for? A highlight. This might be nice for a highlight brush. I don't think it'll be good for, to give you a nice sharp contour to like really get in there, but for a highlight it might be cute. But I figured, I'm like, they're new, they just came out, I have to see how they work because I love Elf brushes. Like, there's not one brush that I don't like from Elf. So yeah, those were from Wet n Wild from Walgreens. As you can see, there's a little Walgreens thingy right there, and they were like between $3 and $4, so pretty much the same price limit, or the prices as Elf brushes. All right, the next thing is, and I got this from another beauty blogger, and I remember like a long, long time ago when I first started makeup, I used to use this all the time, and then I stopped because, I don't know, I got into MAC, into more high-end makeup, and this is from Walmart. This is the Original Formula Airspun Loose Face Powder, and the one I got was the Translucent Extra Coverage. I used this for the first time last night. Oh, I loved it. Like, I put a lot on, because I wanted to like bake my makeup and, you know, my highlight and all that kind of stuff. And then I kind of like took it off, and then I used a little bit of my powder foundation just so I didn't look too powdery, because I wanted to take pictures. But it worked really good with setting my makeup. Like, my makeup looks so flawless. It looks so soft. And this is like $8. Like, and this is a lot of product if you can see it. So I haven't been able to find this anywhere else but Walmart. I don't know if that's the California thing, but maybe CVS Pharmacy has it, but I know out here the only place that had it was Walmart, so I picked that up and kind of happy that I did because I've been enjoying that a lot. While H2O Proof, and this is new as well. This is like a new liquid liner, and I love it because, let me just show you, like the applicator is really nice, so you can get a nice like line, and that's what I'm wearing right now. And it's been pretty good because like it is waterproof, like it stays on all day, and I think it was $2.99, so very happy with that. Okay, also picked up the new Maybelline Dream Velvet Soft Matte Hydrating Foundation. My color is 92 Caramel, and I wanted to see, because I have another haul coming up with high-end products, and I wanted to see if this is anything like the new NARS Velvet Tinted Moisturizer, which is amazing. It's what I'm wearing now. It's like a foundation, but it doesn't feel like a foundation. Like, it's so crazy. But anyway, it's amazing. I love, love, love this new NARS foundation. So when I saw this, I was like, I wonder if this is anything like it. Could it be a dupe? Could it be? Because like, the NARS one is $44 and this one's $8.40 or $8.99. So I'm thinking that it might be a dupe. So we'll see. But this is how it looks. And yeah, so we'll see if that is going to work for a dupe or not. Okay, is that all we have right here? Do we have anything else? Oh, concealer. So recently I picked up the new HD concealer from, Makeup Forever from Sephora. And it was $25. I mean, it was nice, but it creased like so bad. If you didn't set it right when you put that concealer on, it was like crease city. It was ridiculous. So I ended up taking it back because I was like, for $25, it's just not what I wanted. It wasn't up to par. So I picked up the Maybelline, this is new, the Maybelline Master Conceal Camouflaging Concealer in 40 Medium. And that's what I have on right now. Oh, okay, $8.40. So actually, I got this for $8 and this for $8, but it was buy one, get one half off. So I paid like four something for this. So, I mean, I could not believe, and this is the only number 40 they had, so I'm going to go back and get another one because this is amazing. Like, I use it under the eyes. It's creamy. It's blendable. It doesn't crease. I set it right away, and it actually gave me more coverage than the HD concealer from Makeup Forever. So, this is definitely, go out and get it, find your color, and let me know what you think about it because I am absolutely in love with this concealer, and the price, like, you can't beat that with a stick. It's crazy how inexpensive that is. Okay. And I think the last thing I have, oh yeah, okay, so I have more lashes. Actually, I have more things. The next one I picked up was the smudge brush, which is really, really nice for under eye color as well, or blending out, like smoking out your top line. It's a dollar, so I'm like, I always can use those. But I picked up also the liquid liner eyeliner. This is from NYC, and I heard this is really, really good, like comparable to the, what is it called? Is it Benefit, I think? Yeah, Benefit, their real liner. And this is $1.99, so gonna check this out and see how I like that. And then I picked up the Salon Perfect, and this it says blogger favorites on it, so I was like, oh, I have to try that. But this is the 615 and the Perfectly Glamorous Salon Perfect from Walmart. And they look really pretty thick, almost like spiky lashes. They kind of remind me of the Reskeek? I think it's called, or the Mishka lashes from, what is that? I'm having like a brain fart, guys. Where is it from? Oh, it's those lashes that everyone loves. Anyway, I'll put them down in the description bar. I can't remember. But anyway, it reminds me of those. And those were like, I think like $4.99 or $6.99. And this was $2.99. Buy one, get one half off. So not bad. And the last thing I thought was really cool, and I was so mad because people out here love Wet n Wild. So when it comes out, it's gone. And so they only had this color left. But this is the new Wet n Wild Color Icon Ombre Blush. And if you can see, it's like a gorgeous purpley pink, and it goes up to ombre. It ombres to a really like pinky color. I thought that was so pretty. The color this one is called In a Purple Haze, number 317B. So I'm excited to try this. Actually, you know what? I should just like open it up now. I don't think I can because it's like, oof. All right, so I got it open. This is how it looks. It's so, so pretty. And let me just go ahead and just see how this is gonna look. It looks a little powdery. I don't know, guys. Oh, no, actually, you know what? It's actually really pretty. It's very pigmented. And it has like an iridescent kind of look to it. Like it almost can be a highlighter. This is pretty. I have a really pretty lipstick that I will look really nice with this. And I love the ombre purple effect. So that was the last thing, guys. Thank you so much for checking in with me. I'll be back very soon with a tutorial or something exciting for you guys. Put down in there, thumbs the video first and subscribe, please. And tell me what you want to see next. And I'll get on that super fast in a hurry right away. So, all right, guys, have a great day. And I'll talk to you later. Bye.